The death of malls, well documented.
The good memories people used to have here at the mall that's now been turned into a playground for vandals.
Also giving us a look at the progress being made on the demolition at the site of the former Century 3 Mall.
Out with the old and in with the new, where a Searstown Mall is being torn down.
But now, is the mall making a comeback?
Look at the numbers, they bear it out. Indoor malls like this one, foot traffic, visits, up 8.6%. from this time last year. Outdoor malls, everyone loves an outdoor mall, traffic up 6.2%. And what about outlet malls? We all love the outlets too. Over there, it's up, yeah, a green arrow up again, 5.7%. Three green arrows for every type of mall you can think of. So why now? Why this surge now? Turns out you can thank Gen Z.
According to the International Council of Shopping Centers, 97% of Gen Z, the supposed online generation, still shop at brick and mortar stores.
All of a sudden, guess what I'm noticing? My own kids, I have a 12-year-old, a 14-year-old, and an 18-year-old, they're coming to the mall almost every weekend now to hang out with their friends. 60% of Gen Z respondents to a recent survey said, even if they have nothing to buy, they still like coming to the mall now to hang out with friends. But guess what they do inevitably? They walk around, they buy stuff, they buy food, they see something in the window, and they buy stuff. Once they're in the door, malls see that as a win. But our retail expert says there's something malls and stores need to do right now to keep them coming.
Stores really need to focus on the experience to draw people in. Consumers love the opportunity to try and test products. So being able to put items out on display, whether maybe it's a video gaming console where the shoppers can try playing the game, or beauty products where they can test the items and see how it looks on themselves, giving more opportunities like that will really get the shoppers in and engaged in the store and get them to shop more in person.
The biggest increase right now, luxury outlet sales, according to Forbes, up 35% from 2021.
Shoppers are driven by bargains, but people really want quality products as well. And so people are focusing on those luxury brands, but they can't afford them at regular retail. So they're really attracted to those outlet stores that have those discounts on luxury brands.
We're also seeing more in-store only deals, retailers offering you discounts you just can't get online to get you back through their doors. Why do they want you back through the door so much? Because when you're there in person, you're much more likely to grab multiple items than just that one outfit you go online to buy, you buy it, then you log off. By the way, we have more bonus content and deals to save on everything from clothing to furniture in our Rossen Reports newsletter. It's really cool. It comes straight to your inbox. It's free. RossenReports.com. Back to you.